Climate change is here, and it will affect virtually every man, woman, and child on planet Earth. Its impact on the energy sector is explicitly discussed by prominent scientists in research papers, government reports, and utility documents. Their common themes are that energy plays an important role in all aspects of our lives, and increases in temperature mean that there will be an increase in energy demand due to running more air conditioning units in homes and businesses, accommodating more cold storage and refrigerated warehousing of perishables, and having more cooling fans running in place of air conditioners. Global warming is causing more extreme weather, as cyclonic winds are known to topple and collapse transmission towers. Strong updrafts and strong horizontal winds could bring down multiple transmission lines within a single corridor, causing N2 contingency and cutting off power supplies to major load centers. It is time to downsize the national grid to a microgrid that can be operated in island mode and still stay connected to the main power grid for synchronization and support. The concept of a microgrid is not new. What is new is the transformation of a national grid back to a regional network system in the face of emerging technology, falling cost of renewables such as wind turbines and solar panels, and the introduction of small modular reactor SMR. The current development makes it possible. SMR has a generating capacity from about 5 to 272 MW, which is much smaller in size than conventional nuclear reactors and therefore will have lower upfront capital costs, and with enhanced safety features, it will overcome the public sphere mindset of nuclear power plants. A microgrid refers to distributed energy resources and loads that can be operated in a controlled, coordinated way with other local distribution companies, LDCs. With the existing electrical infrastructure set up, it could operate in an island mode. However, it will stay connected to the main power grid for synchronization, for peak shaving during high load demand, for power import during emergency shutdown of the SMR, including during station servicing and maintenance, and for power export to neighboring LDCs. Small modular reactors, SMRs, are advanced nuclear reactors that have a power capacity of up to 300 MW per unit, which is about one-third of the generating capacity of traditional nuclear power reactors. SMRs, which can produce a large amount of low-carbon electricity, are small, physically a fraction of the size of a conventional nuclear power reactor. Modular, making it possible for systems and components to be factory assembled and transported as a unit to a location for installation. Reactors harnessing nuclear fission to generate heat to produce energy. Small modular reactor SMR can play a very significant long-term role, simultaneously addressing challenges associated with global climate and environmental impact. There are 5 different types of SMRs to choose from, and they are 1. Water-cooled reactors. 2. High-temperature gas-cooled reactors. 3. Liquid metal fast neutron reactors. 4. Molten salt reactor. 5. Heat pipe micro-reactors. One of the advantages of the SMR design is that it is based on factory fabrication and testing of modular components that can be shipped for rapid site assembly. It is also based on a walk-away passive safety system that ensures the reactor will never melt down even in a disaster that causes a complete loss of power to the plant site. In addition, it can be fueled with the nuclear waste produced by traditional reactors. In this slide you can see water-cooled reactors, in which all components for steam generation and heat exchange are assembled into a single integrated unit called NuScale Power Module NPM. In this slide you can see high-temperature gas-cooled reactors, which is a small, modular, graphite-moderated and helium-cooled, high-temperature nuclear reactor being developed for industrial process heat, hydrogen production, and electricity generation. This is based on Framatome's and Terry's concept. In this slide you can see liquid metal fast neutron reactors, which uses sodium instead of water, allowing the reactor to operate at ambient pressure. The ARC-100 design ensures that the reactor will never melt down even in a disaster, and that it can be fueled with the nuclear waste produced by traditional reactors. In this slide you can see molten salt reactor uses molten salt rather than solid fuel to carry uranium fluoride for capturing and dissipating heat from the fission process. It uses low enriched uranium less than 5% 235U fuel. In this slide you can see heat pipe micro reactors which develops by Westinghouse having a solid core and advanced heat pipes. The core encapsulates fuel and heat pipes enable passive core heat extraction and power regulation. In this slide you can see SMR reactor sizes. A modern nuclear plant is likely to cost over $6,000 per kW. Some current estimates suggest $12,000 per kW due to cost overruns. SMRs are projected to cost less than a coal-fired plant, between $3,500 per kW and $5,000 per kW, after SMRs are mass-produced in volume in the factory and assemble on site. Since no such reactor has yet been built, there is not much reliable information related to the costs of these technologies besides the vendor estimates and a few research reports. The capital cost estimate for SMR of 250 MW small modular reactor is $6,191 per kW. Among the advanced and renewable technologies, wind turbines are probably the cheapest at around $1,677/kW, with solar photovoltaic power plants close behind at $1,313 per kW. The solution to climate change is finding a clean energy solution such as SMRs and adopt a microgrid network system. Electric vehicles alone will not stop climate change. Small modular reactor SMR technology is becoming more attractive and the possibility of commercial deployment within the next 10 years is feasible. Meanwhile, renewables such as wind turbines and solar photovoltaic systems continue to advance, and with energy storage growing rapidly too, investing in a new microgrid power infrastructure would result in cheap electricity prices. We would see a reduction in greenhouse gas emissions through electrification of energy services such as a carbon-free transportation network, industries that would not burn fossil fuels for energy, and businesses and homes that would cease burning fossil fuels for heat. Fortunately, climate change is solvable. We have the technologies. We have the science. We now need OPG, municipalities and LDCs to have the foresight to change course and build a better future for future generations. Advantages of SMRs. Many of the benefits of SMRs are inherently linked to the nature of their design, small and modular. Given their smaller footprint, SMRs can be sited on locations not suitable for larger nuclear power plants. Prefabricated units of SMRs can be manufactured and then shipped and installed on site, making them more affordable to build than large power reactors, which are often custom designed for a particular location, sometimes leading to construction delays. SMRs offer savings in cost and construction time, and they can be deployed incrementally to match increasing energy demand. One of the challenges to accelerating access to energy is infrastructure, limited grid coverage in rural areas, and the costs of grid connection for rural electrification. A single power plant should represent no more than 10% of the total installed grid capacity. In areas lacking sufficient lines of transmission and grid capacity, SMRs can be installed into an existing grid or remotely off-grid, as a function of its smaller electrical output, providing low-carbon power for industry and the population. This is particularly relevant for microreactors, which are a subset of SMRs designed to generate electrical power typically up to 10 MW. Microreactors have smaller footprints than other SMRs and will be better suited for regions inaccessible to clean, reliable, and affordable energy. Furthermore, microreactors could serve as a backup power supply in emergency situations or replace power generators that are often fueled by diesel, for example, in rural communities or remote businesses. SMRs have reduced fuel requirements. Power plants based on SMRs may require less frequent refueling, every 3 to 7 years, in comparison to between 1 and 2 years for conventional plants. Some SMRs are designed to operate for up to 30 years without refueling. More than 80 commercial SMR designs being developed around the world target varied outputs in different applications, such as electricity, hybrid energy systems, heating, water desalination, and steam for industrial applications. Though SMRs have lower upfront capital cost per unit, their economic competitiveness is still to be proven in practice once they are deployed. Let's see benefits of SMR. 1. Lower initial cost. The capital investment for a single SMR is much less than for a conventional nuclear power plant. To the electric utilities and their investors, this means much less capital at risk by building SMRs instead of conventional nuclear power plants. 2. Simpler environmental impact statement. The physical footprint of a single SMR is much smaller than for a conventional nuclear power plant, and the amount of radioactive material at risk is also much less. 3. Easier public acceptance, lower visibility. Small modular reactors have a much shorter construction time due to their smaller size and modular construction. To the public, the construction of a small modular reactor would appear to be less intrusive than the construction of a shopping mall. 4. Service remote communities without long-distance transmission lines. Small modular reactors lend themselves to installation in remote areas that are not served by the electric grid or not served well by the electric grid. Several proposals for the construction of SMRs advertise this feature as a selling point for SMRs. 5. Modular construction, semi-assembly line manufacturing. SMRs with their modular construction can have all major components assembled off-site, then transported to the operational site for final assembly. This modular construction method makes it appear to the public that the SMR almost magically appears. 6. Short time from groundbreaking to online. With the simplified control systems of the SMR and their modular construction, the period of time from final approval to actually having the SMR on the grid could be well less than 12 months. 7. Simpler NRC approval after first unit. Keeping the SMR modules identical will greatly simplify NRC approvals for additional SMRs either at the same location or separate locations. 8. Smaller impact in the event of an incident. Even in the case of multiple SMRs operating at an individual site, no single SMR incident would be likely to have a dramatic effect on other SMRs operating at that same site. A single SMR has much less radioactive material at risk than a conventional nuclear reactor. Additionally, the SMR designs are more robust than currently operating nuclear power plants. Now see the drawbacks of small modular reactors. 1. Higher initial cost per MW. The estimated initial investment cost per MW is perhaps 50% higher than for a conventional nuclear reactor. 2. More personnel per MW. The earlier statements about SMRs operating without human intervention was obviously an exaggeration. The number of personnel per MW installed will always be higher for an SMR than for a conventional nuclear reactor. Installing multiple SMRs at a single location will somewhat reduce the number of personnel per MW, but will not reduce to the number of personnel required for a conventional nuclear reactor. Need for small modular reactors, SMRs, and decarbonization is very important. Decarbonization challenge. UN Sustainable Development Goal 7 prioritizes making affordable, dependable, and sustainable energy accessible to everyone. Despite progress, 82% of global energy still comes from fossil fuels. Electrification will increase 80% to 150% by 2050, making reliable low-carbon electricity crucial. Reliability in power generation. Recent coal consumption growth in Europe highlights the need for consistent 24/7 low-carbon power, ensuring stable grids and energy security alongside deep decarbonization efforts. Limitations of solar and wind. Relying solely on solar and wind energy poses challenges for consistent power supply. Additional firm power generation technologies are necessary to enhance grid stability and reduce costs in decarbonized energy systems. Critical mineral demand. Clean energy technologies require critical minerals like lithium, nickel, cobalt, and rare earth elements. Their demand could triple by 2030, leading to concerns about capital investments, environmental impacts, and geopolitical risks related to mineral extraction and processing. Role of nuclear power. Nuclear power supplies 10% of global electricity, contributing to reduced natural gas demand and CO2 emissions. Its role is vital in achieving net zero goals, offering continuous power generation and various co-benefits like high-skill jobs. Advantages of SMRs. While conventional nuclear power plants face challenges like time and cost overruns, SMRs offer a solution. With a capacity of up to 300 megawatts, SMRs can complement existing NPPs and be located in repurposed thermal power plant sites, avoiding land acquisition and displacement issues.
Small Modular Reactors, SMRs, are a class of small nuclear fission reactors designed to be built in a factory, shipped to operational sites for installation, and then used to power buildings or other commercial operations. In coming slides, you can see the operational data of worldwide SMRs by types that are in operation or under development. 1. KLT-40S, Russia. This is an existing reactor. 2. HTTR, Japan. This is also an existing reactor. 3. Shidao Bay, China. This is the world's first commercial onshore small modular nuclear reactor. It was connected to China's power grid, making China the first country in the world to draw power from such a machine. 4. Academic Lomonosov, Russia. This is a floating nuclear power plant that has been operating in Russia's Far East since October 2022. 5. NuScale Power, U.S. This is the first working model available to the U.S. market, developed in 2022. The U.S. Department of Energy estimates that the first SMR in the United States will be completed by NuScale Power around 2030. 6. FORS, Japan. This reactor has been pre-reviewed by the U.S. Nuclear Regulatory Commission, NRC. 7. eVinci, U.S. This is another reactor that has been pre-reviewed by the U.S. NRC. 8. Aurora, U.S. This reactor is currently under review by the U.S. NRC. 9. BWRX-300, Japan. This reactor is in Phase 2 of the Vendor Design Review, VDR, by the Canadian Nuclear Safety Commission, CNSC, or in preparation for it. 10. SE-100, U.S. This reactor is also in Phase 2 of the VDR by the CNSC, or in preparation for it. Please note that the development and deployment of SMRs are ongoing, and there are more than 80 modular reactor designs under development in 19 countries.